shadow control. No survivors. Some evidence of UFO.
So it must be that UFO that came in a month ago under a radar blind spot.
And if it stayed underwater, it would escape deterioration in the Earth's atmosphere.
They could even have slipped in a special underwater craft in component sections.
Possibly. They seem to have perfected life maintenance in a liquid environment.
Right. So what do we do next?
A detailed search of the entire area. I'll go myself.
In SkyDiver?
What else?
Well, wouldn't you rather I took over?
Oh, that. Well, the dictionary defines it as a morbid dread of confined spaces. Skydiver's not all that small.
And you're not always morbid.
Exactly.
Get me Skydiver's positional chart.
Yes, sir.
It's in the South Atlantic area, about 400 miles south of St. Helena.
Below, sir. My cabin is at your disposal.
Thank you, Captain.
Do you think we'll find anything?
Well, it's hard to say. But the more I think about it, the more the theory stands up. Well, we know they've taken people from houses in broad daylight.
You mean it'd be a lot easier mid-ocean?
Right.
It's a big place to play cat and mouse.
Yes, but we'll just have to make sure that our claws are well sharpened.
How do you mean?
Well, we're trying to find them. Let's hope that the aliens don't think that we're the mouse.
B-17, sir.
Right, plot a search pattern.
Yes, sir.
Lieutenant?
Sir.
I want a constant radar sweep and sonar sounding.
Yes, sir.
Straker.
We're making the first sweep on the surface, sir.
And we'll be going under for a submerged circuit.
Right.
Carry on, Captain.
Let's make the most of the fresh air.
Starting vector search.
Course 019, veering to 023. Decreasing sweep on 14 degrees port.
Right.
Maintain the watch, Colonel. I'm going below.
Right.
How's it going, Nina?
Fine, sir.
What is it?
Large shoal of fish. Sonar is our best bet.
Well, you're the expert. It's a tight ship, Captain.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sonar echo increasing.
What do you make of it, Lieutenant?
Metallic object. I'm moving quite fast. 60 knots.
How far?
2,000 yards increasing.
Get below, Colonel.
I'm taking it down.
Dive! Dive! Dive!
What is it?
An underwater craft, sir. Moving ahead of us.
Altering course. Veering to starboard. Eight degrees
starboard. Switch on underwater cameras.
Visibility poor, sir. Rock formations. We've lost it.
Rocks don't help.
Bank surface.
Float tanks 1 and 2.
Blowing 1 and 2. Malfunction on 1.
Keep trying those tanks. Hold it! Shut down ballast!
It's heading away, toward the surface.
Can we launch Sky One?
We can try.
All right, Paul.
No good.
What's its attitude?
10 degrees.
It's enough.
Launch Sky One.
Lift off.
Roger.
Sky One airborne, sir.
Sky One to control. Come in, SkyDiver.
Contact lost, sir.
We're going down. Turbine's non-functional.
Shut down the reactor.
Yes, sir.
Prepare to switch to emergency power.
We're still going down.
Emergency power. Crash positions.
Control. Overflying last known position. Still no radio contact. Wreckage apparent. Redocking negative.
Roger, Sky One. Proceed to nearest shadow base. Starting subsmash procedure.
Roger.
Let's get to it. Colonel Foster, the air systems and electrics.
Sir.
Albatross 2-5 to shadow control. We have positive area location on SkyDiver beacon. Homing on signal now.
Roger, Albatross.
Another 50 minutes. What do you think?
No way of telling, sir. Subsmashers are always difficult.
I better check things out in the cabin.
Officer?
Sir.
We'll be there in less than 50 minutes. What do you think their chances are?
Hard to say. By the time we get there, it could be sitting on the surface, waiting for us.
That's not likely, is it? Wreckage.
Till we get there, sir. It's anyone's guess.
Nearly through here, Commander.
How are things astern?
Not good. One turbine completely blown, and there's some damage to the reactor cooling plant.
Well, that means we can forget the main power supply.
How about the air supply, Paul?
Well, it's impossible to be accurate, but I estimate there's enough air for 8 hours. About the same as the batteries.
Lieutenant Lewis, I hope you got some good news for us on those escape hatches.
Well, there's only one of them operational, sir, number 3 hatch, and that's got trouble.
It's working, but the systems check indicates damage. In addition, there's something wrong with the pumps. I reckon it'll take upwards of 90 minutes to empty that hatch.
One escape hatch in commission, and that's only usable every 90 minutes.
What about the missile tubes?
Oh, no go, Commander. The ship's angle rules them out. The rock ledge is blocking the exits.
See what you can do about fixing up those pumps. And double check on those hatches.
Can you get any more speed out of this thing?
Not without blowing our engines to pieces. You know Commander Straker pretty well, don't you?
Yes. Pretty well.
Well, Paul?
We've checked it again, sir. It looks pretty bad.
Well, we'll have to start making for the surface. Now, we've got to phase this pretty carefully. We're working with very little air and practically no time.
I'm a bit worried about the outer door on three. There's indication of severe damage.
What about the pumps?
Well, still no improvement. With the reactor off, the power's very low. What do we tell the crew?
Forget it. They've figured it out for themselves already.
Don't worry, Nina. We'll get out all right.
You've been in this situation before, haven't you?
Yeah, it was a big boat. Full crew, 69 men trapped on the bottom, but we all got out. And we will this time, too.
All right. Let's go over the situation.
Now, there's only one regular escape hatch still working, but its pumps are damaged, as well as its outside door. But there is another emergency escape route through the crash dive flood tube.
We can only use it once.
But it means that two of us will get out immediately. But if it takes 90 minutes to empty the hatch each time, we can all be out of here in 4.5 hours.
You said 4.5 hours, Commander, but at best the air can last only...
You're forgetting one thing, Lieutenant. The fewer people there are down here, the longer the air will last.
Have you decided...
Lieutenant Barry, you will use the crash dive tube.
Yes, sir.
Lewis?
Sir?
You'll have first crack at the escape hatch.
But, sir...
That's an order. And then Colonel Foster. All right, let's get to it.
Anina.
The crash dive tube is the safest way out. But it won't be easy. When we throw the control and the water comes in, it'll hit you like a sledgehammer.
Yes, sir, I know. I used it once during training.
Good, good. It'll only last for a second, and then you'll be okay.
I'll manage.
Right, well, the sooner you get out of here, the more air will be for the rest of us.
There's no chance of our surface vessel getting to the area ahead of us.
Forget it. She's 5 hours away. We're on our own.
Well, there's only a slight swell. We'll be able to handle it.
All set.
Good. Synchronized watches. 15:50.
Check.
Check.
Now we'll blow the hatch in 5 minutes, Lieutenant. Good luck.
Thank you, sir. See you topside.
Hatch flooded, sir. Check. Opened. He's made it.
Nina should be in position now. Prepare to detonate in 20 seconds. Ten seconds. Detonate.
Well, they should be up by now. Straker.
Ed, it's me.
Alec. Thank God.
We've got Lewis.
What did you say?
I said we've got Lewis. He's quite safe. He's explained the situation. Now look, Ed, just hang on.
Alec, have you got Nina?
Nina? No.
She went out right after Lewis.
Well, don't worry, don't worry. We'll get her. We'll find her. Look, Ed.
You've got to conserve your air supply. Now just rest and stay as quiet as possible.
The divers are coming down now.
They'll get you up.
Alec. Alec.
They're slowing down. Death never worried me before. Right now I'm scared.
You're getting older.
How do you mean?
The older you get, the more precious life becomes. You become aware of what life is.
Oh.
time, sir.
All right.
Commander, get moving.
But, sir...
Colonel Foster, get off this boat.
Commander...
You're breathing my oxygen. In you go.
How does it look?
She's jammed fast, sir. The only certain way of moving her is by heavy lifting gear, but we need the salvage vessel for that.
Is there any way we can get an air supply down there?
Negative. I was hoping to use the escape hatch, but it's still flooded.
The pumps must have packed up completely.
It's hopeless.
You'll have to go down there again. And get me a suit, will you?
Sir.
What are you going to do?
I don't know. But we're going to get him out of there somehow.
Thank you.
blow.
It's okay. It's okay.
We're sending them down now.
Right. And send out some more lights.
Right.
Oxygen count down to 15.1. Emergency power failing. Command captain and crew. Note for Dr. Schroeder, subject.
Anyone. I'm glad you're here. I mean, I'm glad. It's you.
Believe it.
So that's the way it happened.
You mean to say you just blew us out of the water?
Well, what else could we do? Holden came up with the idea.
And with SkyDiver off the ledge, the divers got in through the missile tubes.
And that's the way it happened.
I'm afraid the visitors will have to leave now. Oh, I'm sorry, sir. No smoking.
Well, back to the salt mines.
Bye.
Oh, thanks for the cigars, Alec. Well, Nina, we were pretty close down there.
Yes. If there was anything I said which, well...
Or didn't say? That's what life's all about, I guess. The things we never say. Well, they're kicking me out of here this afternoon. I better go and pack my toothbrush. You'll be back on Moonbase in a week or so.
Yes, sir.
Take it easy, Nina.